somebody who has been relentlessly crusading for the declassification of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose's files, and he's written several books and has been addressing this entire issue alongside the family members. Anuj Dhar, finally, today the declassification of files did take place. Are we to understand that this is a systematic declassification process that has just begun? Yes. What are we expecting ahead?
Well, Prime Minister came and he said ki every month 25 files we will release. So we are happy, delighted. I think it's never happened in this country that we are having declassification in such a way. So much of, you know, public attention, media attention, Prime Minister himself coming and releasing it. So thousands of pages have been made public today. It will probably take many, many days at least. You know, I can't possibly take a look at them today. It was fantastic. I mean, I don't know. I don't have words as a researcher. I really can't describe. Suddenly, one swoop, thousands of pages are coming into public domain. And every month, would you believe, 20 files will be made public. So we are talking about hundreds of files. So it will take some time. One has to go through. I have been able to have a cursory look at every page. As a researcher, I'll tell you, every page is important.
Anything that you have picked up as of now?
No, I don't think so. All these files were seen by Justice Mukherjee. I'm talking about the files concerning Netaji's death and so on and so forth. These files were seen by Justice Mukherjee and the verdict is there in the commission reports. So I don't think so that's going to change. Anything is going to change that thing unless until somebody has a political, you know, idea in his head like Ashish Ray Nandan. You can't change that. Apart from, do you have light on many issues like INA treasure and how the treasure was reopened? You have got pictures of opening of the treasure box in the Maharaji Desai's time. You've got a lot of files about Netaji's wife and widow and daughter. Where there's a controversy whether he married or not. So you have those files. So there's a lot of information which is, of course, as I said, every letter, every single line which is declassified has got some importance. But if I'm looking for one particular, you know, line which changes my perception or which, you know, in a big way supports that he either died or did not die, well, I'm afraid I have to look into it. It's thousands of pages.
So that question still remains as to what happened to Netaji in his final days.
Obviously. I mean, I haven't seen the files. I mean, these are thousands of pages we're talking about. They've been just made public. They've gone online. It is going to be very useful. It's going to, you know, spurt, you know this interest
information.
And your database has suddenly increased. So all the files in public domain. It's going to, of course, you know, lead us. As I have been saying all the while that, of course, we must declassify our files. Now we must declassify our intelligence file because intelligence files are very important in this regard.
That brings me to my next question. Last year when you all met the Prime Minister, the entire family members and the delegation from the research scholars and explorers, you all put forth a demand requesting the Prime Minister to also ask other foreign countries to declassify files in their possession.
Yes.
Has that made any momentous move ahead?
Oh, yes, Prime Minister was very clear. See, you know that when a Prime Minister talks to his counterpart in different countries, agenda is discussed in advance, several months, probably, you know, year in advance. So Prime Minister was very clear that when I'm meeting Mr. Putin in December, I would be raising the Netaji issue. And he did. So this I can confirm. The matter has been raised, but I think the Russians, of course, would be wary of a regime change in India. Suppose they declassify certain files about Netaji's presence in Russia. If Congress party, you know, comes to power, then there will be a problem. Relation will be affected. So they will think hundreds of times because the impact it would have on Indian political scenes. But the other thing, I think, unless we declassify our own KGB, our own intelligence bureau and raw papers, I don't think so we are going to get anything from the KGBs. It's not going to work. Same ditto for MI6 to CIA. So Prime Minister has made a good start. He repeated that every month 25 files will be made public. So I hope in the fullness of time, intelligence bureau and raw papers will also be made public.
Thank you so much. That was Anuj Dhar, who says that yes, they have requested the Prime Minister to extend a request to other foreign countries like the US, UK, Germany, Japan and China to also declassify files in their possession, but they are first waiting for our own intelligence and the other such agencies to declassify all the files in their possession. With camera person Sachin Rawat in New Delhi, Samir Kapoor.